the game would enjoy success in its two new cities. The same couldn't be said for Long Island and Atlanta. They were added 2 years later, partly to block the threat of the upstart new World Hockey Association.
Looking at the situation there, it was really different than any other expansion or any other new team coming in, simply because we were not going to be the only team in the market. The New York Rangers were a pretty well-established team. They were probably, if not the best team in the league at that time, certainly the second best. Very strong team with established stars, obviously, you know. With Rod Gilbert and John Rattel and Eddie Jackman and Brad Park, they were serious Stanley Cup contenders, and one could see that they were going to be for the next few years. So, you know, the chance of us really competing for the first few years were pretty slim. Second of all, obviously, the Rangers are the most dominant team PR-wise, as well established. The structure of the league was a lot different then. There were only 14 teams. We were put in the East Division, whereas the Atlanta Flames went in the West. In the East Division, obviously, the Montreal Canadiens, the Boston Bruins, it was a much stronger, tougher division. So it's pretty clear to me that where we were going to end up for the first couple of years. Coinciding with that, the draft then was a 20-year-old draft. You knew that in the next few years, coming out of junior hockey in Canada, there was some really outstanding talent coming. So I simply sat down with the ownership and I said, "Look, we can go piecemeal and try and you know, bring in an old guy here, an old guy there, and create some." Or I said, "We can just go for the entry draft." Spend our time, effort, and money in looking down the road 3 to 5 years. When the Rangers will be a much older team and we'll be a much younger team, and our talent, if we do a good job in our drafting, obviously then we felt we would draw in the New York market, that there were enough obviously in that market that we would be a decent draw even though we weren't winning. So that's basically the approach I took for those reasons. It was a little tough. We only won 12 games the first year. Every city we went into, I remember the headlines, "Here come the hapless Islanders." It was a little tough to take. The expansion draft was not a very generous one. I think there were only 3 established NHL players we got out of the expansion draft, Eddie Westfall being the most obvious. The second year, we made a couple of moves and the team improved. I brought in Al Arbor as the coach, we knocked 100 goals against off our record, which was a big thing. And defensively, we started to get better. And then obviously, we did a good job in the entry draft. Second year, we drafted Denny Potvin, which is obviously the first big step. That's the way we went. It was a tough couple of years to get it off the ground, but once it started to take shape, it was pretty exciting.
Tonelli to Nystrom, he scores! Bob Nystrom scores the goal! The Islanders win the Stanley Cup!
It was very exciting. Just 8 years after that dismal first campaign, the Islanders would go on to win their first of 4 straight Stanley Cups.